The and all the windows fastened down. I spent the night in sleeplessness and rose at every sound, half in hopeless sorrow and half in fear the day would find the soldiers breaking through to drag us all away. Then just before the sunrise, I heard something at the wall. The gate began to rattle, and a voice began to call. I hurried to the window, looked down into the street, expecting swords and torches, and the sound of soldiers' feet. But there was no one there but Mary, so I went down to let her in. Dot stood there beside me as she told us where she'd been. She said they moved him in the night and none of us knows where. Oh, the stone's been rolled away and now his body isn't there. So we both ran to the garden, then John ran on ahead. We found the stone, an empty tomb, just the way that Mary said. Circumstance and speculation couldn't lift me very high, cause I'd seen them crucify him, and then I saw him die. Back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. Everything I promised him just added to my shame. When at last it came to choices, I denied I knew his name. And even if he was alive, it could never be the same. And suddenly, the air was filled with strange and sweet perfume, light that came from everywhere, those shadows from the room. Then Jesus stood before me with his arms held wide, and I fell. And as I looked into his eyes, love was shining out from him like sunlight from the skies. Guilt and my confusion disappeared in sweet release, and every fear I'd ever had just melted into peace.
I just want wanted to say thank you, Teresa, and your crew, for that was beautiful. Thank you for teaching all of our kids that, and for using them to teach it to us. So praise God. We have a little gift for you. Thank you very much.
And again, if there's anyone here that just wants to give their life to Jesus, invite him into their life. He's walked with you today, he's talked to you, and he's gotten the word burning in your hearts. Invite him in. Don't leave today without making him your Lord and Savior and giving your life to him. And what better day than Easter for that to happen? Amen? And you can always come and talk to me, or maybe turn to someone that you came with and ask him to help you lead you in the prayer, and please grab a Bible on your way out. And I'm going to invite you back next Sunday. Every Sunday we're here at 10:30. Let's close in prayer and then we'll sing. So God, thank you so much for your grace. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you, Lord, that you really did rise again from the dead, and you have defeated death and sin forever. And Lord, that you could give us the victory through you. We ask that you would just give us a great day today. May your name be lifted high. Help us to stand in awe of all that you've done for us. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's sing together. I'll stand.
So I'll stand with arms high and heart abandoned in awe of the one who gave it all. I'll stand my soul, Lord, to you surrender all.
God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above.
got the resurrection today. Hey, one more time. Jesus is risen. All right, God bless you. I'll be available down in front if anybody wants to talk to me about starting their journey with the Lord.